Good Friday, everyone. I don't know about you, but I love the changing seasons. I love how the earth transitions from one season to the next. Growing up in Alabama, the only seasons we had were summer and winter. Things went from green to brown and brown to green. I truly love living in an area that has a true fall and a true spring. This week I've seen a few leaves already turning colors, and the squirrels seem extra busy as they anticipate the coming of cooler weather. And Winfrey is getting busy too. I've noticed that things are ramping up for the fall. We have the trunk or treat on Halloween, and the Intergenerational Christmas Craft Day, November 13th, the Rise Against Hunger event on November 20th, just to name a few things that are coming up. I feel that things are getting a little back to normal, but with all the COVID protocols in place, I think we're going to be dealing with this pandemic for quite a while still. With the changing seasons, I find that my heart feels a little lighter with the anticipation of the coming events, activities, and holidays. When I begin to feel like this, I think of some of the Psalms, especially Psalm 100. Listen to this. Shout praises to the Lord, everyone on this earth. Be joyful and sing as you come in to worship the Lord. You know the Lord is God, and God created us, and we belong to the Lord. We are God's people, the sheep of the Lord's pasture. Be thankful and praise the Lord as you enter God's temple. The Lord is good. God's love and faithfulness will last forever. I like that. God's love and faithfulness will last forever. It's good to remind ourselves just how much God loves us and how faithful God is to all of us. It will last forever. What is our response to knowing this? I find that when I'm focusing on God's love for me, I'm more able to show love towards others. And when I think about the many blessings God gives me each and every day, it's easier to share what I have with others. When I feel God's presence in my life, I'm able to express the peace that passes all understanding. My prayer for all of us today is that we would take time away from the divisive politics, opinions, and rhetoric that is seemingly on display everywhere and be an example of God in the world. There seems to be so much unrest in the world right now, people fighting over masks and being unkind on airplanes and in restaurants. If those of us who know God make a concerted effort to be the light in the world God wants us to be, how would that change the world in which we live? I want to challenge all of us to be intentional about letting God use us in this unsettled world. Let's be like Teresa of Avila, a Spanish Carmelite nun in the 1500s. She wrote this, "Christ has no body but yours, no hands, no feet on earth but yours. Yours are the eyes with which God looks compassion on this world. Yours are the feet with which God walks to do good. Yours are the hands with which He blesses all the world. Yours are the hands, yours are the feet, yours are the eyes. You are Christ's body. Christ has no body but yours." Let's pray. Dear God, this world can be in such turmoil at times. Help us to share your peace. Our lives can at times feel unsettled. Help us to feel your presence. This life can feel stressful and unkind. Help us to know your love. May we be your hands, feet, and eyes, sharing your compassion, love, and care to a hurting world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.